In this video, I will teach you how to create installer from JavaFX application. So let's review from previous video. So let's select clean and build to create jar file. So we are successfully creating jar file here. So copy this one. Then cmd. This is the jar file, which is 6 KB. Double click. Okay, there's no output, means there's no window, means there's error. So let's proceed to cmd. Then cd, then java, then negative jar to run the jar file. So let's copy this one, rename, copy, then paste. Then it requires, okay, the error is no main manifest attribute in JavaFX demo in the jar file. So let's add manifest, means let's add manifest file, and inside the manifest file we need to include the main class. So let's close, then proceed to your Google Chrome. Then let's type here Maven shade plugin executable jar with dependencies. Click this one. Then the second option, select this one because it include the manifest file. So copy this plugin, do not include the plugins, copy that one. Okay, copy, then back to NetBeans, then open your POM file, then scroll down, then here in the plugin we need to add plugin. At the end of the plugin, enter, then paste the shade plugin, Maven shade plugin. Then here let's delete this one, build number. Then let's replace this one to our main class. So we need to include our package com dot aldrin, then JavaFX. Then let's type the main class up. Then let's try to clean and build. There's error, so let's try to clean and build. Ano? Build with dependency. Okay, there's no error, so let's open this one. Target. Copy. So we have here jar file, which is 9 KB. Then the last build is, this is 6 KB. So double click this one. As you can see, we have a window here, which is the JavaFX application. We successfully include the manifest file, which is the inside of manifest file. We include the main class. So let's close this one. So the second thing to do is let's add Launch4j. Okay, so here open the directory in our JavaFX demo. Let's add here for example, let's add installer. So let's put the output file, our output file, which is our java exe. The exe file. Click that one. NetBeans, then JavaFX demo. Then select this folder installer. Then let's put name here JavaFX demo.exe. So include that exe. You need to include the extension because that is it is required. So select this one, jar file, then installer, back to the okay, then select this target because inside the target we have here this one. Select the 9MB, open, then find the ICO file which is located, and that I download already the ICO file and the downloads. Select this one. Then in GRE we need to add folder here because we need to include the GRE in our installer. So let's put GRE. Remember this folder. This is the path which is same with the exe path. So click this build wrapper. Then inside the build wrapper here, open the NetBeans, then select this JavaFX demo, then select this installer, then let's put here JavaFX which is .xml, then okay, created. So let's try to run the file. Yeah, it's required the GRE because our path here is no GRE folder. So let's add GRE folder here, new folder, then let's put GRE. Then inside this GRE folder we need to copy the GRE to put in this folder. Open, then program files, then let's open the Zulu. This is our folder. Then this is the folder of the JDK. Inside of this, this is the okay JDK or GRE. So let's back to the documents, then JavaFX demo here in installer. Let's paste here the GRE. Okay, this is the pattern of our creating installer. Okay, this one. So if we click this one, okay, there's no error because we put the path for our GRE. So let's create an installer of this one. So close this one. Then let's open the Eno set Eno setup. Oh, Eno setup. Then close. Then select this file, new, next. Then let's put here JavaFX setup, the name of application, or JavaFX demo. Then this, the version is 1.0.0. The next. Then this is the destination of the default, a default destination program files. Then the name of the our folder here is JavaFX demo. The next, then let's create installer. So in our documents, let's open the exe that we create. JavaFX demo, this one, target, installer, this one, then add folder, then let's browse the GRE because we include the GRE. Okay. GRE, JavaFX demo, then installer. Okay. Yes. Okay, installer. Then we include the GRE folder. So, I'm sorry guys, we include this .exe because inside the installer, we include these files. So, okay, there's no problem with that. Then click next. Then this is JavaFX demo. Then next. Then custom compiler output. Let's open this one. Then documents. Then NetBeans. Then JavaFX demo. Then okay. That is the output folder. Then let's put here JavaFX setup. Okay. Then the icon. So I browse, I already download the ICO file located in my documents. So we don't need the set up the we don't need to set up the password in this application. So next, finish. You would like to compile with a new script now? Yes. You would like to save the script before compiling? Yes, because this is required. Do not click this one. No. To continue, so let's put here JavaFX, then save. Then process cannot be accessed because it's being used to the another process. Continue. Why? Let's close this one. Let's play again. Because of the CMD. Okay. Let's wait for 2 minutes. Oh no. This is good because when we install it, when we install the application to other computer, there's no need to install the JDK because we package the JDK or GRE in this application. For example, if we don't include, but the problem is in the other computer, they installed already the Oracle JDK, there's a problem of that because it won't run the application because it requires the JavaFX library, which is in the Oracle JDK, they don't include the JavaFX library. But in Azul Zulu, they include the JavaFX library. So let's wait for a while. So let's close this one. Twenty-five seconds. This is the estimated. Four, three, two, one. Yeah, it is done. Then here in JavaFX demo, let's quit. Here in our JavaFX demo, this is the location, this is the installer that we create. So let's close that one. Then let's uninstall the JDK. So control panel, we need to uninstall the Azul Zulu JDK uninstall. Yes. So close. Then, as you can see here in the target, if we double click this one, it won't run because there's no available JDK. So, in this computer, we don't have a JDK, so we need to proceed to install this program, run as administrator. Yes. This is the default. Yes, next. Create shortcut. Next. Next, install. As you can see here, we include that GRE folder. Okay. Click finish. Yeah. We create the installer successfully. Close this one. Close. Okay. Then if we click this one. Yeah. We include the GRE. So let's right click this one. Open the file location. So here we have the GRE package. So thank you for watching, guys. See you next video. In next video, I will teach you how to install JavaFX using IntelliJ IDEA. So see you next video. Bye.